Okay, so let's start. And now, see, yesterday I think we have finished solid sphere, right? Now, concentric shells, concentric cells. Now see here, this is the first cell, and this is another shell. Like this, two shells are there. Now, this white one is having a radius, let us suppose B. What is the radius? B. Small b. And this red one is having radius, that is, let us suppose, small c. What is that? Small c. And I'm taking a point out of these two shells, which is at distance, let us suppose A. Okay. Right. Now this white shell is having mass, let us suppose M1, and this red shell is having mass M2. And now here is a point. So what will be the gravitational field intensity at this point, even in between? Okay. Right. And at point A, B, and C, what it will be? Let's see, right? So, see now. First of all, at point C, see here what I am writing. At point C. Now, at point C means you will get gravitational field intensity due to M1 or M2. Tell me. Due to M1 or M2, shell. You will get only because of this M2. Because inside this M1, there is zero due to this M1. Hena? Yesterday, we have learned this. Spherical shell, inside the spherical shell, gravitational field intensity is equal to zero. Spherical shell mein dekha hai humne, hai na? Yes. Now here at point C, gravitational field intensity due to mass M1 is going to be zero, whereas gravitational field intensity due to M2 is equal to what? G M2 by B square or C square, bolo.
What time hota hai?
Kya hoga? GM2 by B square hoga ya to phir kya hoga, bolo. C square hoga. C square hoga na? Kya hoga? Socho. C square. यहाँ पे सी स्क्वायर लिख दूँ? यस, है कि नहीं है? सही है ना? कहाँ पे लिया है मैंने? एट पॉइंट सी। तो मैं एक काम करता हूं, सबसे पहले यहाँ पे कुछ पॉइंट्स नोट करता हूँ। रुको, ये है मेरा कैपिटल ए पॉइंट, ओके, जो कि बाहर है। उसके बाद जो बी पॉइंट है वो मैं लेता हूं। कहाँ पे ले लो बी पॉइंट? तो मैं लेता हूं समवेयर हियर, बिकॉज दिस पॉइंट्स आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट। ऑन दिस शेल लेता हूं मैं ये बी पॉइंट, ओके। और जो सी पॉइंट है, सी पॉइंट वो मैं लेता हूं समवेयर इनसाइड हियर, दिस इज व्हाट सी पॉइंट। ठीक है, राइट। अब देखो एट पॉइंट सी अगर हम बात करें तो ये ई एम टू भी क्या हो जाएगा रे? एट पॉइंट सी पे जीरो हो जाएगा ना, अगर मैं इनसाइड की बात करूं तो। सही है ना? अगर मैंने पॉइंट इनसाइड लिया है तो ये भी जीरो आ जाएगा ना, इनसाइड इनसाइड द बोथ, इनसाइड द बोथ स्फेरिकल शेल, देयर इज नो मास प्रेजेंट। यहाँ पे आप देखो ये वाला, यहाँ पे सी पॉइंट, ये रेडियस तो सी है ही, लेकिन ये सी पॉइंट लिया है मैंने। देन ई एम वन एंड ई एम टू विल बी जीरो। नेक्स्ट देखो एट पॉइंट बी, एट पॉइंट बी कहाँ पे है? पॉइंट बी कहाँ पे लिया है हमने? इसके ऊपर लिया है। तो E ड्यू टू यम वन क्या होगा बोलो? E ड्यू टू यम वन हो जाएगा जीरो, क्योंकि दिस इज इनसाइड है ना। एंड E ड्यू टू यम टू क्या हो जाएगा? E ड्यू टू यम टू क्या हो जाएगा बोलो? G यम टू बाई सी स्क्वायर। सही है क्या? राइट, क्लियर है? ओके। और उसके बाद अगर मैंने पॉइंट ए पे लिया है, यस, फाइ ई एम वन इज जीरो हियर एट पॉइंट बी बिकॉज दिस इज एम वन शेल एंड द पॉइंट बी इज इनसाइड द एम वन शेल, दैट्स व्हाई देयर इज नो ग्रेविटेशनल फील्ड इंटेंसिटी ड्यू टू दिस मास एम वन। ओके, ओनली ग्रेविटेशनल फील्ड इंटेंसिटी इज ड्यू टू दिस एम टू मास ओनली, अंडरस्टूड? दैट्स व्हाई दिस इज जीरो, दिस इज नॉट जीरो। हियर इन दिस केस इट इज इनसाइड द बोथ शेल्स, सो देयर इज नो मास प्रेजेंट, आइदर नॉट ड्यू टू एम वन नॉट ड्यू टू एम टू, दैट्स व्हाई बोथ आर जीरो। नाउ नेक्स्ट वन यू सी, एट पॉइंट ए, एट पॉइंट ए यू सी व्हाट इज पॉइंट ए? At point A means where ray outside. So here you will get both the gravitational field intensities. Either because of M1, what you will get? G M1 by A square and E because of M2 is equal to, E because of M2 is equal to क्या जाएगा? G M2 divided by A square only, this distance only at this point, okay? ठीक है ना? Because point is outside, that's why at point A you will get the gravitational field intensity due to both the masses, and therefore E total at point A is equal to G by A square into M1 plus M2. This is what the net gravitational field intensity at that point. Yes, clear hai?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Sir, we have to draw diagram also.
Yes, yes. Yes, finished.
1 minute, sir.
Note down.
Completed, sir.
Okay. Now see. Now you tell me. Earth is a solid sphere, right or wrong? Agree with me? Yes or no? Earth is a solid sphere. Yes or no? Bolo re. So as it is a solid sphere, like this, and suppose now one point mass is situated somewhere here, then gravitational field intensity on the surface is equal to G, bolo, G. Gm by r square, and this is nothing but equal to what, right? Gravity on the surface of the earth, okay, right? And therefore gravitational field intensity at the surface of earth is equal to gravity, yes or no? And therefore E at surface is equal to G into, or G by R square into, this is M, and we know rho is equal to M by V, therefore M is equal to rho into V, and this is rho into 4 by 3 pi R cube. So this is equal to G by R square into 4 by 3 pi R cube into rho. This R square and this will get cancelled. And what is the answer? 4 by 3 pi r rho g. This is also another formula for gravitational field intensity due to or on the surface of the earth in terms of density and radius. Any doubt, please ask. Any doubt? Yes, any doubt?
No doubt, sir.
Note down fast. You see, you don't keep it in mind formulas, everything is, what you can say, related to one another. For example, this gravity formula only, now this is 4 by 3 pi r rho g. In terms of density and radius, already we have discussed, same, that is only now. Why to count it as a different formula? Already I said here, on the surface of Earth, gravitational field intensity is nothing but acceleration due to gravity. So whatever the acceleration due to gravity formula is there on the surface of Earth, you can use for the gravitational field intensity. Understood? Clear? Yes, finished?
Yes, sir.
Right. Now, you see, in the force, we have learned one null point formula. Do you remember? Null point formula means where the net gravitational field is zero, or where the gravitational force is zero. Yes or no? We have learned, no? Do you remember? This is M1. This
E
is...
by under root M2 by M1 plus 1.
Why, hai na? So see here, this is what? The line joining, and let us suppose this is the point, something P we can say. And it is at distance, suppose x. What is the distance? X. Then, what is the null point formula? X is equal to d divided by under root of m2 by m1 plus 1. Same formula as we have used for force. Okay, clear? Where this distance is how much? D. Same formula even for gravitational field strength also. Same like force. Now, what to do if suppose they will ask you to find gravitational field intensity at some point, at midpoint, we can say. See here, gravitational field intensity, gravitational field intensity at midpoint. Okay, for coming exam, you have only gravitation chapter. Keep it in mind, up to covered. So whatever things we have finished, you have to study well. Only gravitation, 25 questions, 20 MCQ, 5 integer. And on this topic also, you may get one question. Which one? This one, field intensity at midpoint. So listen carefully. Now, suppose you are having a mass here and here. This is what M1, this is what M2, and this distance is, let us suppose, D. And now, exactly at this point, you have to find the gravitational field intensity, that is P point. So, as this is a midpoint, what is this distance, Ray? Tell me how much distance. Bolo.
by 2.
Yes, this one is d by 2, this one is d by 2. Now at this point you see gravitational field intensity due to m2 is where? In this direction. And due to m1 is where? In this direction. Hai ki nahi? Kis direction? Is direction mein. Hai ki nahi? Right, because it is towards the mass. So this is what E1, this is what E2. Agree with me? Yes or no? Bolo.
Yes, sir.
Now tell me what is the E1 value? E1 is equal to Gm1 by D by 2 whole square. Call this equation number 1. And E2 is equal to Gm2 divided by D by 2 whole square. Call this equation number 2. And E net is equal to E1 minus E2. Why? Because both are in opposite direction. Understood clearly? Yes. Just you have to fill the values and you can solve the problem. Clear? Yes.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Note down fast. Yes, clear हो गया. Okay. Next. Now see, gravitational potential. Next topic is what? Gravitational potential. Gravitational potential. अब देखो, what is this gravitational potential? So first of all, see the definition. It is the amount. You see, I think in the electricity chapter in lower classes. Have you learned potential, amount of work done to bring unit positive charge from infinity to given point? Yes. Have you learned this?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Same like that only. You keep it in mind that what? It is what? The amount of work done in bringing a unit mass. That's it. Okay. There it is unit positive charge, here it is unit mass. Nothing difference, same definition. Okay, understood? The amount of work done, to bring or in bringing a unit positive charge from infinity to given point. Okay, what is the definition? The amount of work done in bringing a unit positive charge from infinity to given point. Now, how we can find gravitational potential due to a point mass? Gravitational potential due to a point mass. ठीक है, कैसे करेंगे? अब देखो, there you have learned V is equal to W by Q formula. Do you know? There you have learned this formula, V is equal to W by Q. Do you know? Yes or no? Tell me.
Yes.
Yes. There you have learned this formula. Here we have to learn W by just M. Understand? Is that clear? Just Q you have to replace with M. Now, let's see how it is. So, I am giving subheading, that is gravitational potential due to a point mass. So, in this only, potential due to a point mass. Now, let us suppose here is a mass capital M and you are bringing one small mass M from somewhere infinity, we can say, and keeping at this point, which is at distance, let us suppose R from this capital M. And now this is point P. Now, first of all, we have to find work done, no? Right? And this M is equal to what, Ray? 1, hai ki nahi? M is nothing but test mass, unit mass, we can say. Unit positive charge hai na? So, yahan pe kya likhenge? Idhar dekho. Ye kya likhenge aap yahan pe? Unit mass likhenge khali. Samajh mein aaya? Kya likhenge? A unit mass from infinity to given point. वहां पे हमने क्या लिया था? The amount of work done in bringing a unit positive charge from infinity to given point. In this, amount of work done in bringing a unit mass from infinity to given point. Now here you see this is a mass from infinity and I am bringing at distance r. Okay? Now, first of all, I want to find force in between these two from gravitational force, we can say GMM divided by R square. Agree with me? Yes. Now we know work formula. Work is equal to what, Ray? Force into displacement. So, yeah, now work is equal to force into displacement. So what you will get? Tell me what you will get. W is equal to F into S. Hai na? F into S. But if I want small work done dW, can I write like this? F into displacement is here. dr. Okay? Why? Because this displacement is what here? R. Getting my point, understanding. Yes? Okay? Yes or no? Understanding? Yes. Tell me.
Yes, sir.
Work is equal to force into displacement.
Yes,
this formula you know, na? Work is equal to force into displacement. So force into R I am taking, and this is small work done. That's why small displacement. dW is equal to F into dr. Now, can I write like this? dW is equal to F into dr, and therefore F is g m by r square into dr. This is what dW. Now I want complete work. That's why what I am doing, I am integrating. Integration of dW. Bolo. Integration of dW. W. Hai na? And this you are bringing from infinity to R. That's why lower limit is infinity, upper limit is small r. Now, what is constant here? G m is constant. And here it is what? 1 by r square dr from infinity to r. Now, let's solve this. What you will get? G m divided by nothing, hai na? How much you can write here, or what you will write here? Tell me. What you will write? This 1 by r square I can write like this, na? R power minus 2 dr infinity to r. So what you will get? In the last class I told you x power n dx. What you will get? X power n plus 1 by n plus 1. So here what you will get, Ray? Bolo bolo. G m divided by, wait, next step I will write. GMM, this one, and this is how much? R power minus 2 plus 1 by minus 2 plus 1 infinity to R. Samajh mein aa raha hai? Yes or no? Bolo. You can speak na. Yes or
yes,
no?
Yes, sir.
Now see, can
yes,
I write
sir.
Directly like this?
Yes,
GMM into minus 1 by R. Agree with me? This is minus 2 plus 1 means minus 1. Minus 2 plus 1 means minus 1. Minus 1, and this is r power minus 1. So minus 1 by r. Now put upper limit, subtract lower limit. So what you will get? W is equal to g m minus 1 by r minus of minus 1 by infinity. This is going to be 0. So what you are getting? W is equal to g m by r. This is what? Minus. Yes or no? Clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now you see on the next page, work done to bring unit mass. Na, there it is, unit positive charge in electricity. Here it is unit positive mass. Now V is equal to what, Ray? W by m. Hai na? So V is equal to minus G m by R divided by this small m. This small m will get cancelled. And gravitational potential formula is what? G m by R. Understood? Clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Formula is important.
Yes,
that is what gravitational potential. Any doubt in the previous page I am showing you? Which one? This one, right? Check it once. Any doubt in this page? ये जो रेफरेंस हमने लिया है ये आपको पता है, मैंने पिछले पेयर भी बोला था, है ना? I told no this one. You can write somewhere here this side with different color. That is integration of x power n dx is equal to x power n plus 1 by n plus 1. Hai na? And this is infinity to r. Yes, no, this formula, you know this. Noted this all? Noted or not?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So next page is this. Note down.